stone like at midnight, suspended in my masquerade. I combed my hair till it was just right and commanded the night brigade. I was open to pain and crossed by the rain, and I walked on a crooked crutch. I strolled all alone through a fallout zone, came out with my soul untouched. I hid in a cloud and ran for the crowd. When they said sit down, I stood up. Piracy flew from my mast, and my sails were set wing to wing. I had a jukebox graduate for first mate. She couldn't sail, but she sure could sing. I pushed B-52 and bombed them with the blues, with my gear set stubborn on standard. I broke all the rules, strafed my old high school, never once gave thought to landing. Come down, I threw up. Ooh, growing up. Now, I've never held an honest job in my entire life. I've never done any hard labor. I've never worked 9 to 5. I've never worked 5 days a week until right now. I don't like it. I've never seen the inside of a factory, and yet it's all I've ever written about. Standing before you is a man who has become wildly and absurdly successful, writing about something of which he has had absolutely no personal experience. I made it all up. That's how good I am. Now how? I'm sure you're wondering, how did this great miracle come to pass? Well, in the beginning, there was a great darkness upon the waters. As a child, it was Christmas, your birthday, summer vacation. But the rest of life was a lifeless, sucking black hole. A lifeless, sucking black hole of homework, church, school, homework, church, school, homework, church, school, green beans, green beans, fucking green beans. But then, in a blinding flash of sanctified light, a human being, and just a kid from the southern sticks, but a new kind of man. And he split the world in two. And suddenly, new world existed. The one below your belt. And above your heart. Sunday night in 1956, 39 and a half Institute Street into a cold water flat and into the mind of a 7-year-old kid, the revolution had been televised right under the noses of the powers that be, who, if they'd have known what was actually happening and the changes that were about to come, they would have shut this shit down. Or more likely signed it up real quick, because we, the unwashed, the invisible, the powerless, the kids, would want more. Now, more life, more love, and more sex, and more hope, and more truth, and more power, and more soul, and most of all, more rock and roll. So I sat with my mom, my little seven-year-old mind on fire, staring into a blue tube as fun happened. Fun, the real kind. The joyful, life-affirming, hip-shaking, ass-quaking, guitar-playing, mind and heart-changing, race-challenging, soul-lifting bliss of a freer existence. A freer existence exploded into unsuspecting homes all across America on a regular Sunday night. The world had fucking changed in an instant, in a sweating, wet orgasm of fun. And all you needed to do to get a taste of it was to risk being your true self. Because the rock and roll genie had been let out of the bottle, and he told us that if you were born in the USA, my fellow citizens, these feelings, these freedoms, this fun was your birthright. I listened, I believed, and I heard a mighty call to action. So, I studied my new hero. I know today he's got the same two arms, two legs, two eyes that I got. Yes, he's a human Adonis. And I'm... pathetically creepy. But I'll figure that part out, all right? The one thing he had that I didn't have was strapped around his waist. It was the guitar. The guitar, or as my father had christened it, that fucking guitar. But that fucking guitar was the key. It was the sword in the stone. It was the staff of righteousness. And they sell them at Western Auto downtown for $25. So I begged and I pleaded with my mother just to rent me, because we couldn't afford to buy a guitar from Mike Thiel's Music School on South Street. One Saturday afternoon, I brought it home. And I sat on a living room couch. And I unlatched its full alligator case. And I slowly opened it up. And up from the green velvet lining came the sweet smell of a cherrywood cocktail of power, pleasure, salvation, dreams, and dreams, and dreams. So I took lessons, dedicatedly. I took lessons for 2 solid weeks. And I quit. It was too fucking hard. Learning the guitar, not only was it fucking hard, but the lessons were boring. Just give me the 3 magic chords, please, and let me twist and shout. But I was a 7-year-old kid, and my hands barely fit around the neck, and I couldn't waste my mother's hard-earned cash week after week. So very shortly, I knew that back it was going to have to go. But the morning before I returned it, I strapped it on one more time. I took it out into the backyard where the neighborhood kids were. And I put on my first show. Woo! I slapped it. I shook it. I shouted. I sang voodoo nonsense. I burned a hole in the grass. I shook my little 7-year-old ass. Most importantly, I posed with it. That's the shit. I danced with it. I did everything but play it. I couldn't do that. I stuck so bad, and the kids laughed and laughed and laughed at my silly ass. And we brought it back that afternoon. Riding back home with my mom in the car, sat in the back seat, and I was quiet. I was thinking. I was a little disappointed. and myself. But somewhere inside, I knew that for a moment, just a moment, in front of those kids in that backyard, I smelled blood. I took month-long vacations in the stratosphere. You know, it's really hard to hold your breath. Swear I lost everything I ever loved or feared. I was a cosmic kid in full costume dress. My feet, they finally took root in the earth. But I got me a nice little place in the stars. I swear I found the key to the universe. In the engine of an old parked car, I hid in a cloud and wrath of the crowd. When they said sit down, I stood up. Gonna be